Choosing a major early in your college life has proven to be an indicator of career success. If you already know what you want to do for a career, our series will help you choose a major that will match your career path. I'm Scott Wyatt, president of Southern Utah University, and we strive to provide relevant education for you to meet your career goals. What spotlight do we have today, Ellen?
This is Spotlight on Biology with Dr. William Heybourne. Thank you so much for being with us today.
Thanks, Ellen.
So tell me, how did you get into this field?
When I came to university, I thought I was going to be a veterinarian, and then got a taste of some research and really, really liked that and decided, hey, I can make a career out of this. And so I've been a biology major ever since.
So what other types of people are kind of drawn to biology?
I think the best biology students are students who are naturally inquisitive, who just spend a lot of time looking around at the natural world and asking lots of questions. And then I think a second trait that is really imperative for a science student is to just have a really strong work ethic. And if we flip that around and think about maybe students that won't be as successful in the sciences, if you're looking for all the answers, go somewhere else, right? If you're naturally curious and have lots of questions and want to pursue answers, then come on over to the sciences and we'll help you.
What types of jobs are available after studying this?
Yeah, so, you know, right now it seems like a lot of the jobs for kind of entry level, so right with a bachelor's degree, right out of college, are kind of at this intersection between technology and other science disciplines. And so, you know, if people are interested in going into industry, I would encourage them to really get a very broad science background. Take some computer science classes, take a lot of chemistry, take some physics, because that seems to be where the jobs are. Strictly for biology, a lot of the folks who leave our program go to work for the land management agencies, resource management agencies, so the Bureau of Land Management or the Forest Service, state parks, those sorts of places. And then of course those that go on to graduate school and professional school. So a really diverse group. We've intentionally built research experiences into our courses, even our you know, first year freshman level courses, at a time when lots of universities are cutting labs for introductory courses. We're trying to ramp ours up and make them, you know, more hands-on, more reflective of what it's really like to be a scientist. And so we put a lot of resources into those early courses. And then you couple that with the really awesome pre-professional programs that we've developed here over the years in partnership with the Rural Health Scholars Program. And, you know, we have acceptance rates into pharmacy school and medical school and dental school that are just, you know, unsurpassed. We have among the highest acceptance rates in the state, and if not the country, just doing some really great things here. So students can get a real top-notch education.
That's great. Well, thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks, Ellen.
This has been Spotlight on Biology with Dr. William Heybourne.